but he wants to be the complete player, and he says, even when I go 0 for 4, if we win that game and I caught a good game, I have something to hang my head proudly for.
Willie talked about it in yesterday's game, getting his catcher's reward.
In the air to deep left center field. Andrew Jones will watch this one go out of here. Fourth homer for Mike Piazza.
He is always going to get his hitter's reward. So I'm sure catching a good ball game just makes it feel better. He's a guy that if you let him extend, can hit it out to any part of this ballpark.
Fourth home run, fifth RBI for Piazza. Mets are on the board. It's now 5-1.
Well, he got strike one and strike two with quality pitches, but the 3-2 pitch cut back over the plate and just split the heart of it right above the knees.
Now Edgardo Alfonzo off to a 375 start. No homers yet, four RBIs. Deep center field. Andrew Jones to the warning track, to the wall. Second home run of the night for Mike Piazza. And you don't see many go out in straightaway center here at Shea. That's his second of the night, his fifth of the year. 6-2 Atlanta.
That home run might displease some people, but it doesn't me. I like what Damian Moss did. He went right after the guy, and he took it out to the deepest part. You're right, not too many go out there, but we've seen two tonight. Didn't quite get it out away from him as far as he wanted, maybe, or as low, but he kept throwing strikes with the lead. I think that's what you want to do.
A two home run night for Piazza. Here is Alfonso, who has bounced to the pitcher and walked. 6 runs, 11 hits for Atlanta. 2 runs, 4 hits now for the Mets.
See Henry Blanco do this. Henry Blanco knows how to catch and knows how to lead pitchers. I'm probably asking him or just telling him, hey, don't worry about that home run. That's over. Nothing you can do about it. Stick with your strikes. When he has thrown strikes tonight and pitched ahead in the count, it's been hard for the Mets to get anything on him.
Here's the 2-0. Trying to stop his swing. And went around, says Angel Hernandez. It's 2-1.
You know, I know we said that's not a high pitch count, and that's true, but he may be getting a little tired because all his pitches are starting to get up, aren't they?
A little bit.
He was nailing it down around the knees for most of the ball game.
Deep left center field. Andrew Jones on the run for this one. It's off the top of the wall. And that'll be a double for Edgardo Alfonso. The Mets are waking up here in the seventh inning. Hit number 5 off of Damian Moss.
Another fastball up, but that's out away from him. That's a pitch I don't think he would have handled last year, but he's healthy this year and strong enough to take one on the outer half of the plate and pull it up against the left center field fence.
Now Jeromy Burnitz, who has struck out. And hit into a double play.
Braves with nobody left-handed throwing in the bullpen, only a right-hander. Probably if Moss can get Burnitz, that might be the end of the night for him anyway.
Almost an overshift on in the infield with Percal playing almost directly behind the bag at second. That was one of those twists by Burnitz, where it looked like he was trying to get out of the way, but he actually turned into that pitch.
Yeah,
he was trying to get hit.
Get another base runner.
In the right center field. That's going to fall. Alfonso rounding third. Burnitz on his way to second. 2 runs are in the inning. It's now 6-3 Atlanta. Burnitz driving in his 8th run of the year.
know what this is all about. I have no idea what that was all about.
The foul playing way over behind the runner at second. All that left side of the infield wide open if McEwen could steer one through there. Outfield chaining around toward right as well. Hits it right where Andrew Jones is playing him. He only had to back up about four steps. Tagging at second. Burnitz coming over to third. No throw. One out. And now Ordonez. He's one for two. He had a single in the second inning. Climbed to left in the fifth. But inexplicably, the defensive problems have continued. His eighth error of the season tonight. And another ball took a bad hop that was ruled a base hit. And we've seen Ordonez make plays on over and over again. They've really been on him here in New York.
And he's been on Darren Holmes most of the time. Eight at bats, but he's three out of eight against him.
Infield in at the corners. Ordonez taking ball one. Not only have the fans been on Ray Ordonez, but the media here in New York can be a little tough on you when things are not going your way. They had a picture in the Daily News this morning of Ray Ordonez sipping out of a paper cup in the dugout when he wasn't playing yesterday. I'm going to read you the caption for the picture. Squeezes on, gets the bunt down perfectly. Holmes, no play. Ordonez has won the fans back with a perfectly executed suicide squeeze. And now it's 6-4.
You don't think of a squeeze, I think, defensively when you got them by three. But Bobby Valentine will pull out all the stops, and that's a beautiful bunt. Not only will Burnett score, but Holmes unable to pick it up and throw him out at first, and that's a base hit at an RBI.
6-4, and Mark Johnson now pinch hitting. And here comes Bobby Cox again. The caption under the picture of Ordonez sipping out of a cup in the dugout while not playing in yesterday's game said, quote, Ray Ordonez manages to not drop his drink while taking in yesterday's game from the dugout. This year. 6-6. Braves got five in the second. Mets have gotten five here in the seventh. Left side. Pascal can't get it. Payton went against the defense that the Braves had set for him. They thought he was going to hit the ball to the right side, either in the air or on the ground.
And that's the first time that Hammond, since he's been in the ballgame, has missed that down and away spot. This fastball came back over the heart of the plate. He's thrown about 12 in a row where the catcher hadn't had to move his mitt.
And that enabled Payton to sneak it between for Colin Castilla. Now Roberto Alomar.
He could probably get to something and keep Cedeno or Payton from scoring.
There you go. They don't even check. Well, will they do it again? Back in the 10th inning, Edgardo Alfonzo was walked intentionally.
Double switch. We're not going to find out.
Looks like they're going to bring on a right-hander to go after Alfonso this time. In a minor league trade. In mid-spring for the Braves, as a non-roster pitcher, started out the year at Richmond. And then when all those moves were made, Albie Lopez and Ennis being called up. And then Grabowski coming up when Ennis went down.
Little flare, base hit, around third, Payton heading home, and the New York Mets have come from behind to beat the Braves in 12. Final score, 7-6. Had a 6-1 lead going into the seventh inning in this game. But it's the Mets emerging with a win. Fifth RBI of the year, his third hit of the night.
For tonight's game. For the visiting Braves, 6 runs, 12 hits, and no errors. For the Mets, 7 runs, 13 hits, and 1 error.
And Bobby Cox, heartbroken as the Braves drop one that they thought they had.
Our play of the game is Edgardo Alfonzo, his game-winning single.
I'm sorry, I thought you said...